Oh yeah. Welcome to the, oh wait, we're not doing a podcast. But we're gonna talk about podcasting today. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into it. Today, I wanna chat about podcasting and why every graphic designer should be using it to grow their business, to grow their brand, and increase their visibility. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Hey guys, this is Adrian Boysel, and welcome back to another training video. Today, I wanna talk to you guys about podcasting. As you can see here, I have this mic on my right. Actually it's your right, it's my left, your right. But I have this mic right here, and you can use something simple like this as a USB mic that can plug right into your computer. You could take a little lavalier mic like this and go right into an audio in your phone. There's a lot of different ways that you can create podcasts, and a lot of people overthink it. And so today I want to talk about that. But first, please hit that like and subscribe button. Please drop a comment, introduce who you are, because it helps the YouTube's algorithm bring more visibility to my channel, which is gonna help more people just like you. So let's go. All right, so podcasting. You may have not heard about podcasting, but millions and millions of people have. They actually did some statistics at Statistia and a couple other websites like Chartable, and they have found that podcasting has grown in popularity by over 30% just in the last year. These are stats from 2019 to 2020. And so podcasting is seeing huge growth, majorly in part because of the fact that smart speakers are becoming more and more popular. There are like 60 million smart speakers in the US now, which is a lot. And so because it's so easy to access podcasts on smart speakers, a lot more people are listening. And so I wanna talk to you guys about podcasting, talk to you guys about the importance of podcasting and why you should be using it for your business. A podcast is simply an audio recording that can be anywhere from 5 minutes. I've heard very short podcasts and as long as 2 hours. If you listen to Tim Ferriss, he's got an amazing podcast. Podcasting is really neat. There's no video involved. It's very simple. And then you can use a third-party app like Libsyn. There's Audio Boom, which is what I've used for years. There's different platforms where you can upload your podcasts into, and these are called distribution platforms. And what they do is they will distribute your audio, your recordings, to the different platforms like Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, CastBox. These are all the different platforms that are actually people are listening to. And so it's really important that you understand that you're just gonna focus on having good quality audio. You can use a desktop Blue Yeti. You can use the Boom little mic like I showed you in the beginning. You can have a mic just like this. There's a lot of different ways that you can podcast, but the focus is the content. That is what's the key. So I wanna make sure that you guys have good quality content when you're doing your podcasting. And there's a lot of reasons that I'm gonna cover today, 7 things specifically of why you should be using podcasting and things that I just want you to take into consideration. So first, I wanna talk to you a little bit about the statistics. I did touch on that a little bit, but it's really important that you understand 200 million people are familiar with what podcasting is now. One of the stats that actually blew my mind, because I'm a faith-based person, I love going to church, and even though I haven't been in a while because of everything that's going on in our country and in our world, there are more people listening to podcasts now than there on a weekly basis than there are even going to church. So understanding the popularity and the increase because of the smart speakers and just the accessibility, you can do it from your phone, you can do it so easily just by downloading an app. Podcasting is only increasing in popularity and it's probably not gonna stop anytime soon. But what platform should you be on? Well, you can sign up on a distribution platform like I talked about, but it's really important that you understand Apple Podcasts is still the king. The iTunes store and putting your podcast on there is where you're gonna drive a ton of traffic back to your website if you do it right. The goal is to get on the top 100, and I don't wanna go too far into those details, but if you can get on the top 100 list, you'll get thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, if not millions of downloads on your podcast, depending on the niche. And a lot of people miss some of the golden opportunities within podcasting to actually get ranked on there. But that's not the point of this video. The point is understanding the basis of it and why, what are the 7 things that you need to have as part of launching a podcast for your business and why it's important. Number one is you can reach influencers, celebrities, and thought leaders for your podcast that is gonna help you increase your credibility. You are going to be able to put yourself in front of people who could be potential clients. A lot of the podcast guests that I've had, I've pitched client work to, and I've actually gotten clients from this. I've interviewed people like Jeff Hoffman. If you don't know who Jeff Hoffman is, he's the founder of Priceline.com. I interviewed Nicholas Barely, who's the founder of Billion Dollar Brotherhood, which is a multimillionaire. I've interviewed some amazing people on my podcast simply for the fact that I have a very specific niche. I am a business mentorship podcast. And so these mentors and thought leaders want to give back. And these people are looking for exposure on their own brand. And so they actually came and spoke on my podcast for free. What other platform in the world can you get in front of a thought leader like that and build a relationship with a thought leader and actually be able to have that one-on-one dialogue with them and be able to share that with the world? It's an amazing opportunity for you as a business owner. You can get right past the gatekeepers and you can get right to the decision makers, which are these big thought leaders and entrepreneurs. Number two, when you start actually putting yourself on podcasts with big names like that, you position yourself as the authority. Not only does having big names help you, but at the same time, you're covering topics that you know really well about your industry, your service, your product, whatever it is that you're talking about, you become the authority. When you're the authority in your space, you position yourself differently from everybody else. And so you want to make sure that you find a micro niche and that you're an authority inside of that niche. Being an authority is going to give you more credibility, you'll be able to charge more, you'll be able to get more clients, and that's a really important part of being a business owner is having authority. Who doesn't want to have authority, right? Number three, and this comes with the authority, is attracting new clients. Not only can you get those thought leaders to be clients of yours if you have a good sales process in line of nurturing those relationships, but the people that are listening to your podcast will also seek you out to hire you for work or hire you or buy a product from you or try an affiliate product. There's a lot of people that actually sell affiliate products on their podcast, and so they'll drop a link in the description, which is a little golden nugget for you. You can drop your links in your description, but you want to make sure you don't shortcut your description and make it brief. You want to make it nice and thorough, almost like a blog article. That's the way your podcast is going to really be successful, and just make sure that you're going after a niche. But it's going to help you get clients in your niche and if you go after the right people. If I were to start a podcast all over again and do something new, it would purely be to go after new clients. I already have my mentorship one just to give free knowledge and value, but I also am going to start one eventually here to actually share and bring in clients for my own businesses. Number four, and this is one of the most important things that I've used for it, is it helps me create amazing content. Whether it's a blog article on my website or a blog article on Medium or it's a YouTube video, you can take just an image and put the little sound waves and upload your audio with that, and you can upload that to your YouTube channel. There's lots of ways to create good content. You can take these long podcasts or short podcasts and you can cut them down and make really good micro content. And the biggest thing that you can do, and I've seen a few people do this now in my own circle, is you take those podcast episodes and you actually turn it into a book. If you did an episode every single day, 7 days a week, for 365 days, guess what? You have more than enough content for a book. In fact, you could probably do that for just 6 months and you'd have enough content for a book. So a podcast is a really good way to be accountable, to be consistent, to help you create other content that's gonna drive in great traffic to your website and all the other sources that you have. All right, number five, and this is a very big deal because a lot of people are afraid to podcast because they think it's expensive. The actuality is it's not. You can get started on apps and programs like Libsyn for very affordable, $10 to $20 to $30 at the most per month. And then you can go buy a $30, $40 mic on Amazon. I bought this mic here for $30 on Amazon. The one on my desk was about $30, $40. So it's very affordable to actually start a podcast. And there's not a lot of marketing methods. Even YouTube is a lot more expensive because there's video editing involved and a lot of tools that you need to be able to make videos like this happen. But podcasting is very affordable and you can pretty much do it anywhere. Timothy Ferris, when he was doing his podcast, he was sitting in a cafe in the middle of Europe. I think it was in Paris or something like that, creating content that was amazing. And I've listened to many, many of his interviews, and he's even interviewed people while he's sitting in cafes. Number six, and this is one of the most important reasons to have a podcast to begin with, is traffic. Every business owner, every entrepreneur, every person that's trying to build a brand needs to drive traffic, whether it's to their landing page, their social media, their Instagram, their YouTube, like this, right? I'm trying to drive traffic to this. And the way that you do that is through search engine optimization. If you don't know what that is, it's about going and finding keywords that people are searching that have high demand and hopefully low competition that you can rank for. And once you've ranked for that keyword, you start to own that keyword. Just like if you go to YouTube right now and you type in graphic designer, you're gonna see my videos show up at the top. If you have the right titles with the right keywords there, you have the right description with the right keywords inside of the description, and you maybe have a link or two going outward to your website, to your funnels, to whatever it is you're trying to drive traffic to, SEO on podcasts is super powerful. And if you do it right, that SEO will help you rank all the way at the very top of the charts. So it's important that you actually don't shortcut this step. Make sure you put tags, make sure you put all the different things that need to be inside of your podcast. I'm not gonna do that on this video and go too deep into that, but I just wanted to make sure that you understand that SEO is a very important piece of podcasting, just like YouTube videos. So make sure you focus on your SEO within your podcast episodes and don't shortcut your descriptions. And number seven, this is the seventh reason why you should start a graphic design podcast or any kind of design podcast. If you're a business owner, freelancer, or even just working for a company, you can start to document your stuff, and it's gonna help you come up with great ideas from the guests that you have on, from the research that you're doing. It's gonna push you, especially if you commit to doing a podcast weekly, it's gonna push you to learn, to grow, to become a student. And that's one of the greatest things that it did for me. When I first started my podcast, I started reading my Bible on a regular basis. And when I was reading my Bible, I was discovering things about leadership and even marketing and even sales and building relationships with people. And that my Bible, it forced me to be in my Bible on a consistent basis, and that helped me grow as a person. And then I had amazing experts like Jeff and some of the other people on my show, and that knowledge that they shared, that they dropped, the wisdom, I was able to also learn as well. I've gone back and listened to my own podcast episodes on numerous occasions to be able to remember some of the amazing content that experts in their field and thought leaders have left. So that's a really big one, is it's an opportunity for you to grow, to become a student, and create new ideas that you can go out and share with the world and be able to expand upon it. Once you start that snowball rolling, it just builds and builds and builds, and next thing you know, you have so much content you don't even know what to do with it. And that's the kind of problem that you want to have. So these are the seven reasons that I want you to start a podcast. Remember, focus most of your traffic on Apple Podcasts versus Spotify Podcasts. Spotify did double in traffic, which is awesome. But if you focus on giving your attention and focusing as much traffic as you can on the Apple Podcasts, they will reward you and help you rank at the top. So I hope this helped you guys out. Podcasting is an absolute no-brainer. It's only gonna increase in popularity. And although there are a ton of people jumping on the podcasting bandwagon right now, there's still plenty of opportunity, especially if you're doing a daily or multi-time per week podcast. So hope you guys enjoyed this. I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. We're gonna have some fun on that one too. So make sure you subscribe, make sure you like, and make sure you drop a comment. I wanna hear from you. So I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Adrian Boysel, and as always, keep looking up.